went on and we got comfortable and we started to play our game. We got to the third period and we were playing really well and they ended up getting one, and then we regrouped in the locker room and came out and got the job done.
Yeah, so Sean McBride, he tried to do a wraparound attempt and the goalie saved it, and I got the rebound and I just wrapped it around as well and ended up going in.
I mean, it's an amazing feeling, especially in the playoffs, and just really happy for the team win. It looked bad for a little bit when we scored on a minute left. You know, you feel down, but we regrouped in the locker room and came back strong. So I'm really proud of the boys.
Yeah, I think we come out pretty strong, actually. We do get the first goal. That is very important, and I feel like I see a lot of pucks out there, so that makes it a lot easier for me. So, yeah, and it gets a little shaky there at the end, but we felt confidence, and we got the job done.
We had a really good third period. Everyone thought that we played some of our best hockey, so it was just stick to it and eventually one will go in. I didn't even know that was a stat. So
2012 was the last time. So.
Yeah, that's pretty crazy. But no, we're not worried about that. We know what we could do in our locker room, and we're just gonna come out and play how we play. Yeah, not much really. We just need to play AIC hockey, and if we do enough right things in the game, we'll get the win.
Thought we had some nerves first period, and I thought we continuously got better as the game went along. We kind of settled, first goal kind of settled us down a little bit, and I thought we were really, really good in the second. Would have been nice to stretch the lead there. Third period, we managed the game fairly well for about 18 minutes and 55 seconds. And, you know, credit Robert Morris, they seem to do that, and you know, by no means we think it'd be easy. And you know, we just said, hey, everything at the net in overtime, and our penalty kill was fantastic for the most part. We chip in a power play goal, and we're excited. It's hard to win games right now, and so we want to apologize for it. We need to play him more. You know, he was a big factor in the Army series for us, creating offense, and you know, we've been using him as the 13th forward. He's a guy that can play anywhere, left, center, and right, so he's a nice gadget player. He's a guy that's kind of stuck with it here for us. Not playing as much as he would probably like to, but give him credit. You know what, big night, big spot, and it's a good time for your first goal. You know, we talked about that we were playing a darn good hockey game, and these things happen, and it's not going to be easy. And, you know, we kind of painted a picture. Sean McBride scored an overtime goal in this building last year in the playoffs, and we wanted to paint a picture of what's the celebration going to look like. It's going to be a good one. And so we just tried. You know, it's tough when a team gets a goal that lead on you and you walk in the room and it's pretty darn quiet. But, we're a resilient group, and champions at times have to battle through some of this adversity. And I don't want to say never a doubt, but our guys have a strong belief in them right now, so proud of them. And you know what, in the playoffs, your best guys have to elevate. She won't be playing very long, and Blake's been a big game performer, and I thought he was the best player on the ice tonight. Him and Zack Skog were brilliant, and the thing about us and the way we're built is, you know, we come at you with four lines, and we don't really shorten four lines and 6D, and as you see, we use our extra guy as well, so hope it bodes well for two games in 24 hours here. And, but to your question there, Blake elevated. So all year, our prep work is done. We've prepped for both these teams, so it's just a matter of picking which file we're going to grab at the end of this game. I'll probably hang around for a period or so, and for our guys, it's always about us, and it's always about our preparation, and we're not opponent-driven. We'll have some tendencies on some special teams, but we are not an opponent-driven program here. We feel like if we're doing what we're supposed to be doing and playing to our identity, that's the best formula and best recipe for us. We can't be experts on our opponents, so we try and be experts on us.